大家好，奉主耶稣基督的名祝福大家。
Greetings to all of you. We bless you in the name of Jesus.
也求主耶稣的圣灵引导我们进入他的真理。
May the Spirit of the Lord lead us into His truth.
今天要跟大家分享的主题是静默有时，言语有时。
The title of my message is A Time to be Silent and a Time to Speak.
在传道书的第三章第一节说，凡事都有定期，天下万物都有定时。
In Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1 says there's a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven.
第七节就说静默有时，言语有时。
Verse 7 it says a time to be silent and a time to speak.
那么应该是静默的时候比较多呢，还是言语的时候比较多呢？
Which is more, a time to be silent or a time to speak?
神给我们一张的嘴巴，两个耳朵。
God gave us one mouth and two ears.
你想想，如果我们有两张的嘴巴，一个长在左边，一个长在右边。
Imagine if you have two mouths, one on the left, the other on the right.
一边可以说话，另一边可以吃东西。
One side can speak and another side can eat.
而只有一个的耳朵在中间。
And only one ear in the middle.
那将会是多么的难看呢？
It will be awful.
但是神给我们两个耳朵，一张的嘴巴。
And yet God gave us two ears and one mouth.
我想神的心意是要我们听多过我们说。
I'm sure it's the will of God for us to listen more and speak less.
你看我们的耳朵随时都在听。
That our ears are always listening.
但是我们的嘴巴却不一定都在说话。
Yet our mouth is not speaking all the time.
除了吃东西之外呢，也有我们沉默不语的时候。
Other than eating, there are times that we are silent.
雅各书也告诉我们要快快的听，慢慢的说。
In the book of James, it says, quick to listen and slow to speak.
我们常听到人说官字有两个口。
We always say the official characters has two mouths.
意思说一个人当官之后呢，他就很会说了。
It means when a person becomes an official, it will speak very well.
但是他却听不到了人民的心声。
And yet they cannot hear the heartbeat of the people.
一个人如果他常常的说，一直的说，他就听不到了。
Yet a person who keeps speaking, he will not be able to listen.
所以箴言书十八章十三节就说呢，不先聆听就回答的，这就是他的愚妄和羞辱了。
In Proverbs 18:13 says, "He who answers before listening, that is his folly and his shame."
如果今天你有心事想找人倾诉
，If you have something in your heart and you want to confide with someone,
你会找什么人来谈心呢
？Who would you share your heart?
当然你会找那些会聆听的人。
You will look for people who will listen.
你不会去找那些强盗式的聆听者。
You will not look for those bandit listeners.
他只是会抢夺你表达自我感受和想法的机会。
He will only rob your speaking and want to spell out his thoughts.
他就在那边滔滔不绝，口沫横飞。
He will probably keep speaking and expressing his thoughts.
当你跟他诉苦的时候
，and when you confide with him,
他就告诉你，我以前比你更惨了，我以前比你更苦。
He will probably tell you, I'm even worse than you. I suffer more than you.
路苦不挖苦
that you suffer, I'm even worse.
你看婚姻夫妻之间常常会发生问题，最主要的其中一个原因就是在沟通上出了问题。
One of the worst problems between marriages is the communication problem.
在恋爱的时候就是女的讲男的听。
During courtship, the female will speak and the boyfriend will listen.
结了婚之后呢，就是男的讲女的听。
After marriage, the man will speak and the woman will listen.
但是老了的时候就两个一起讲，没人听，只有邻居在听。
During old age, both will be speaking and no one listen except the neighbors.
你看听这个的繁体字是你看到我讲写，以前我们读小学的时候那个听就是很多的笔画，所以呢很讨厌写这个的听字。
During my primary time, look at the Chinese character, the traditional character of listen has a lot of strokes, and I hate to write these words.
所以这个听呢，就一个耳朵旁，然后一个得，就是耳有所得的意思。
That this character has a ear at the side means your ear will gain.
然后那个耳字呢，下面有个的听，就是声音的意思。
And there's another word underneath.
就是用 耳朵去感受声音。
Meaning, use your ear to feel the voice.
哦，有一个十字，一个四，一心，就是十面四方一心的听。
That you can see the cross, it means surrounding and listen to the sound wholeheartedly.
今天呢，简体字呢就简化为一个听，就是一个口，一个经。
But now the word has been simplified with a mouth at the side.
你看以前的听就是耳字旁的，现在的听是口字旁的。
The word before the traditional is with the ear at the side, but now with the simplified is with the mouth at the side.
也许今天的人比较喜欢讲话。
Maybe the modern days people love to talk.
一听到口水多过糖。
And they speak so much.
就是要别人来听。
And so that others can listen.
我们的祷告就是与神的交谈，与神的对话。
Our prayers is a dialogue with God.
你看，交谈跟对话是双向的，不是单向的。
Dialogue is actually two ways, not one way.
不是我们一直在讲，一直在讲，就把我们所要讲的告诉神，神只在听。
It's not about we speaking to God all the time and God just be a listener.
其实当我们还没有讲的时候，神都已经知道了。
Actually, before we speak, God knows everything.
但是他也很喜欢我们来到他的面前，表达我们的心声，我们跟他倾心吐意，我们跟他谈话。
Yet God loves to see us coming to near Him to speak and express our hearts and communicating with Him.
但是祷告更重要的是，是让神来对我们说话。
Actually, more important in prayer is let God speak to us.
今年我们为国家四十天禁食祷告的主题是：你们要休息，要知道我是神。
The title for this year, Fast and Pray, is Be Still and Know That I Am God.
就是诗篇的四十六篇第十节。
It's from Psalms 46, verse 10.
你们要休息。
Be still.
并不是说我们什么都不做。
Be still does not mean we do nothing.
哎呀，反正什么都不能做了。
And there's nothing much we can do now.
这个的疫情的肆虐，这个的经济，这个的政治的动荡，我们也无能为力，不是在我们的掌控之内的。
The political, the economic condition, all these are beyond our control.
其实神告诉我们，你们要休息，休息的目的是要知道他是神。
Yet God told us, be still.And know that I am God.
休息是要让我们更多的认识神，认识他是谁。
Be still so that we know God more and who God is.
认识神的属性，认识神的旨意，他的应许。
Know His attributes, His will, and His promises.
认识他的全能，他的伟大，他的荣耀。
His power, His sovereignty, and His glory.
如果我们休息了，却没有更多的认识神。
Yet, even we are still and do not know God more.
那么那个不叫休息，那个叫睡觉。
Then it will not cause stillness, but sleeping.
一觉醒来呢，还是什么都不知道。
When you woke up, you know nothing.
在这个祷告的手册呢，也有给这个的休息一个的定义。
In this prayer booklet, there's a definition for stillness.
希伯来字的原文叫做 Rapha.
The original Hebrew word used for being still is Rapha.
Rapha 就是停止挣扎。
Stop striving.
要放手交给神。
And let go.
愿意将自己交托给神，并让他掌权。
Willing to submit yourself to God and let Him control.
全然的降服于他。
Surrender to Him.
要放松。
To slacken off.
不要干事。
And leave it alone.
在神的面前是脆弱的。
And become weak before God.
当然我们在面对世界，面对仇敌，我们要刚强壮胆。
But we must be courageous and bold in the world.
但在神的面前，我们承认我们软弱，我们需要他。
And yet before God, we admit that we are weak and we need Him.
而且是从容的，不惊慌的。
And to be quiet and not worrisome.
放下。
Let go.
安静，沉默。
Silent.
不活动或静止。
Inactive.Or still.
所以要休息是要知道他是神。
Therefore, be still and know that I'm God.
今天我们来看看安静的一个目的。第一点就是我们要安静是要我们能够仰望神，观看神的作为。
Let's look at some purposes of stillness. The first point is rest. Look to God and watch His deeds.
在出埃及记的第二章二十三节、二十四节，这里说过了很久，埃及王死了。以色列人在困锁中叹息，他们就呼求， 在捆锁中的呼求达到神那里。
Exodus 2:23-24 says, "During that long period, the king of Egypt died. The Israelites groaned in their slavery and cried out, and their cry for help because of their slavery went up to God."
以色列人他们在埃及做苦工，他们在捆锁当中，他们非常的痛苦。
Israelites suffered during the bondage of slavery.
他们在捆锁中叹息，他们向神呼求。
They cry out to God during that slavery.
他们说：“神啊，我们受不了，我们顶不顺了，快来救我们吧。”
They cry out to God, "God, we suffer so much and we can't stand it anymore. Please come and save us."
你看，在捆锁中，他们的呼求就达到神那里。
And during that slavery, their cry out reached to God.
神有没有听见他们的呼求呢？
That they God listened to their cry.
二十四节就说：“神听见他们的呼声。”然后他就纪念他与亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各所立的约。
Verse 24 says, God heard their groaning and remembered His covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
神听到他百姓在痛苦中的呼求。
Then God heard the cry of His people in their suffering.
神也看见他们的苦情。
And yet God see their predicament.
神是守约、是慈爱的神。
God is a covenant God.
于是他就呼召了摩西，要把以色列的百姓从埃及为奴之地带出来。
Therefore, God called Moses to lead the Israelites out of Egypt.
今天也有很多人是活在水深火热的中间。
Today, many people are actually living in troubles.
活在这个捆锁、这个的劳苦愁烦、绝望的当中。
They are bound. They are in a hopelessness.
如果今天你不认识神
，Today, if you do not know God.
你就不能够依靠他，你就不能求他来帮助。
You cannot trust him and rely him for him to help you.
你就求助无门。
You are helpless.
求天不应，叫地不灵。
Cry out to God and yet there's no answer even from the earth.
那么你就只有叹息。当你面对困苦的时候，你就只有叹息。
You will only groan in your suffering.
你却没有求告的对象。
And you do not have an object for you to cry out.
你一切的痛苦，一切的重担，就只有自己在默默的承受。
You're only carrying your own burdens and suffering.
直到你倒下去。
Until you collapse.
然后在第三章的第七节。
And in verse chapter 3, verse 7.
上帝就呼召摩西。
And the Lord called Moses.
上帝对摩西说。我的子民在埃及所受的痛苦，我实在看见了。
The Lord said, "I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt."
他们因受杜贡的辖制所发的呼声，我也听见了。
And I have heard their crying because of the slave drivers.
他们的痛苦我是知道的。
I know their pain.
神说他们的痛苦我看见了，我听见了，我知道了。
The Lord said, "I have seen, I have heard, and I'm concerned."
弟兄姐妹们，今天你所受的痛苦，你以为没有人看见，但是神都看见了。
Brother, sister, the suffering that you face today, you think no one can see, but the Lord saw.
神看见你的苦情，他看到你的委屈，他看到你的所流下的眼泪。
The Lord has seen your suffering, your cries, even your tears.
他看到你付出的一切的代价，他看到你所受的羞辱。
He can even see what you have paid the price for and even the humiliation that you received.
然后他说，你发出来的呼声我也听见了。
And he even said, "I've heard your crying out."
当你在祷告的时候，你以为神听不见。
Sometimes when we pray, we think God does not listen.
但是神要告诉你，孩子，你所做的每一个的祷告，你所流下的每一滴的眼泪，我都看见了，我都听见了。
Yet today, the Lord is telling you, every prayer and every tears that you shed, I have seen, I have heard.
神说你所受的痛苦，我也知道了。
The Lord said, "The pain that you suffer, I know."
所以神不只是看到你外在所受的痛苦。
Therefore, God does not only see your external suffering.
他也看见你内心的痛苦、内心的挣扎、内心的纠结。
And yet, He can see your inner struggle.
他看到你里面的无奈和心酸。
He sees the helplessness in you.
所以神都看见了。
Therefore, God sees everything.
那他说：“所以我下来要救他们脱离埃及人的手。”
Therefore, the Lord said, "I've come down to rescue them from the hand of the Egyptians."
我要领他们脱离那地，到美好宽阔之地，到牛奶鱼米之地。
And bring them out of that land into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey.
神说我要带领我的百姓走出生命的苦难。
The Lord says, "I want to bring my people out of their suffering."
我要带领他们进入那宽阔之地。 就是流奶与蜜的应许之地。
And lead them into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey.
现在以色列人的呼声已经达到我的面前，我看见了埃及人对他们所受的压迫。
And now the cry of the Israelites has reached me, and I've seen the way the Egyptians are oppressing them.
所以现在你来，我要派你到法老那里去，使你可以把我的人民以色列人从埃及领出来。
So now go, I'm sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people to the Israelites out of Egypt.
然后故事的发展呢，就是摩西就硬着头皮去见法老。
And the story continued that Moses brazenly approached the Pharaoh.
然后就要求法老允许他把以色列人带走。
And asking the Pharaoh to request him so that he can bring the Israelites out.
当然他面对了法老百般的刁难，百般的拦阻。
Yet he faced many difficulties and hindrances from Pharaoh.
但是神与摩西同在。
But God was with Moses.
神就用十个的灾难来惩罚这些埃及人。
And God used 10 plagues to punish the Egyptians.
法老王在没有办法之下呢，就唯有允许他们离开。
And when Pharaoh come to an end, finally allowed the Israelites to leave.
然后摩西就带着几百万的以色列人，浩浩荡荡的要走出埃及。
And Moses led millions of Israelites out of Egypt.
当他们走到这个红海的边缘，
When they come to the Red Sea,
只要过了红海就出了埃及。
Once they cross the Red Sea, they are out of Egypt.
但是这个时候，这个法老王就反悔了。
But now the Pharaoh regretted.
他就带着千军万马就来追杀他们。
And he led his army to go after the Israelites.
要把他们尽都歼灭。
And to kill all of them.
就是在十四章出埃及的十四章第十节这里说呢，当他们走到红海边，法老走近的时候，以色列人举目观看，看见埃及人正追赶过来。
Chapter 14 it says, as Pharaoh approached, the Israelites looked up, and there were the Egyptians marching after them. They were terrified and cried out to the Lord.
他们看见埃及的千军万马，沙尘滚滚地杀过来。
They saw the Egyptians' army, tens of thousands coming after them.
他们听见他们震耳欲聋的杀喊声。
And they can hear their battle cries.
然后就是以色列的百姓，他们只是奴隶，他们不会征战。
And these Israelites, they were only slaves, they could not fight.
他们手无寸铁，没有武器。
They have no weapons at all.
他们偕老扶幼，身边很多的老人家，很多的小孩。
They were old and young together with them.
眼见他们就要经历一场的大屠杀，都被杀光。
And they are actually facing the total killing of all of them.
他们就非常的惧怕，他们在极度的恐慌惧怕的当中，他们又在向耶和华呼求。
Yet when they were afraid and terrified, they cry out to the Lord again.
他们怎样呼求呢？
How did they cry out?
他们就对摩西说，
They told Moses,
难道埃及没有坟墓吗？
Was it because there were no graves in Egypt?
你要把我们带来死在旷野吗？
That you brought us to the desert to die?
你为什么这样待我们？
What have you done to us?
Why? Tell me why.
Why? Tell me why.
把我们从埃及领出来呢？
Then you led us out of Egypt.
我们在埃及的时候，我们不是对你说过吗？
Didn't we say to you in Egypt?
我说不要管我们，
Leave、
我们要
us alone.
服侍埃及人。
Let us serve the Egyptians.
因为服侍埃及人比死在旷野还好。
It would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the desert.
你看，与其说他们是在祷告，不如说是在埋怨。
Instead of saying they are praying, they are actually complaining.
他们在埋怨摩西。
They were complaining against Moses.
其实他们在埋怨神。
Actually, they are complaining against God.
因为把他们带出来不是摩西的意思，是神吩咐他。
Because it was not Moses' will to bring them out of Egypt, but the Lord told Moses to do.
而且神也是因为回应这些以色列人他们在痛苦中的哀求，才要把他们带出来。
And it's actually the response from the Lord when God heard their cry to bring them out of slavery.
今天我们有没有常常听到一些很像祷告的埋怨
？Today, aren't we listen to a lot of prayers that sounds more like complaining?
所以听起来是祷告，其实都在埋怨。
It seems like prayer, actually they are complaining.
前面的债务还没有清还，后面债主又追上来了。
And there are debt in front of you, and the creditors are after you.
生病了却不能进到医院，因为医院都爆满了。
And when someone fell sick, they could not even be admitted to a hospital because it was full.
被困在家里，面对家人的争执还有摩擦，但是却不能够出去偷偷去。
And bound at home and have all this domestic conflict, and yet cannot step out.
一个问题还没有解决，下一个问题又来了。
Problems after problems.
所以很多人都在这种的挣扎的当中，这种恼怒心中的那种的怨愤，许多的埋怨。
During this struggle, there are a lot of complaints within.
但是神怎样回应他们呢
？But how did God respond to them?
神就透过摩西对他们说：“不要惧怕，要站着。”观看耶和华今天为你们施行的拯救。
To Moses, Moses answered the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand firm, and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring you today."
耶和华必为你们征战，你们必须安静，不要作声。
The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still.
耶和华对摩西说。
Then the Lord said to Moses,
你为什么向我呼求呢
？Why are you crying out to me?
这个时候不是呼求的时候。
This is not the time to cry out.
你要吩咐以色列人往前走。
You must tell the Israelites to move on.
因为神早就叫他们往前走，要跨过红海。
Because God has actually instructed them to cross the Red Sea to move on.
你要把你的杖举起来，向海伸手，把海分开。叫以色列人下到海中走干地。
Raise your staff, stretch out your hand over the sea, and divide the water so that the Israelites can go through the sea and dry ground.
看啊，我必在法老和他的全军身上，以及他的马刺和马兵身上得到荣耀。
And I will gain glory to Pharaoh and all his army, to his chariots and his horsemen.
我在法老身上，以及他的马刺和马兵身上。得到荣耀的时候，埃及人就知道我是耶和华。
The Egyptians will know that I am the Lord when I gain glory to Pharaoh, his chariots, and his horsemen.
所以神叫他们要安静的仰望神，就是要观看神的作为。
Therefore, the Lord asked them to rest, look to God, and watch His deeds.
你们要站着，不要惧怕。
You must stand firm and do not be afraid.
你们要安静，要观看神的作为。
Be still and watch the deeds of God.
观看神如何为你们征战。
To watch how God will fight for you.
如何为你们得胜。
How He will overcome for you.
如何在你们当中施行拯救
，and how he will deliver you。
神要在你们的当中彰显他奇妙的作为，还有他的荣耀。
Today God wants to demonstrate His deeds and His glory。
你看，他说，当你我得到荣耀的时候，埃及人就知道我是耶和华。
He said, when I gain the glory, the Egyptians will know that I am the Lord。
不只是你们看到我的荣耀，埃及人也要看到我的荣耀，他们就知道我是耶和华。
Not only you will see my glory, the Egyptians will see my glory and know that I am the Lord.
弟兄姐妹们
，Brothers sisters，
今天你为你的问题祷告求告神了没有
？Have you prayed for your problems？
如果你已经祷告了，那么神说我已经听见了。我已经知道了你的诉求。
If you have prayed and the Lord say, "I heard and I'm concerned and know your prayers,"
那么你就可以凭信心安静的仰望神。
Then by faith you can be still and look to God.
你要观看神在你的生命中施展大能。
And watch the mighty works of God in your life.
彰显他的荣耀。
And to manifest His glory.
不只是你能够更多的知道神，认识他的荣耀。
Not only you will know God, you will know His glory.
你身边的人，他们也要看见神的荣耀。透过你的身上彰显。
Even the people around you will know God's glory through you.
不只是那些还没有信主的家人朋友。
Not only the non-believers of your friends and relatives.
甚至那些的逼迫你苦待的人，他们要在你的身上看见神的能力、他的作为、他的荣耀。
Even your persecutors will see the glory and the deeds of the Lord in your life.
Amen.
Amen.
所以第一点呢，就是安静仰望神，观看神的作为。
The first point is rest, look to God and watch His deeds.
第二点就是要安静的信靠神，等待神的时间。
Second point is rest, trust in God and wait for His timing.
是摩西把以色列的百姓带领他们跨过红海，走出埃及。
Moses led the Israelites to cross the Red Sea.
但是在四十年之后，却是约书亚带领他们跨越约旦河走进应许之地。
But 40 years later, it was Joshua to lead them to cross the River Jordan into the Promised Land.
他们过了约旦河所面对的第一个的拦阻，第一个的挑战就是耶利哥城。
The first challenge after crossing Jordan River is the city of Jericho.
耶利哥城呢，是又高大又坚固的城墙。
City of Jericho is tall and fortified city.
里面有强大的敌人。
They have strong enemy.
然后他们的城门是紧紧的关闭。
And the city gate was closed tightly.
摆在他们眼前的是一个不可能攻破的城墙。
What is in front of them is a fortified city that they cannot take down.
是一个不可能去跨越的拦阻。
It's a hindrance that impossible to cross.
然而神却在这个时候教他们绕城七日。
Yet the Lord told them to march around for 7 days.
这就是在约书亚第六章第八节。
Recorded in Joshua chapter 6, verse 8 to 10.
约书亚就吩咐人民以后，七个祭司就拿个七个的羊角走在耶和华的前面，并且吹角，耶和华的月柜在他们后面跟着走。
When Joshua had spoken to the people, seven priests carrying the seven trumpets before the Lord went forward, blowing their trumpets, and the Ark of the Lord's Covenant followed them.
月柜就代表神与他们同在。
The Ark of Covenant represents the presence of the Lord.
然后拿着武器的人就走在吹角的祭司前面，在月柜后面也有防卫的队伍跟着走，祭司一面走就一面的吹角。
And the armed guard marched ahead of the priests who blew the trumpets, and the rear guard followed the Ark. All this time the trumpets were sounding.
第十节，约书亚吩咐人民说：“你们不可呼喊，不可让人听见你们的声音。”
Joshua commanded the people, "Do not give a war cry, do not raise your voices."
连一句话也不可出口。
Do not even say a word.
只等到我吩咐你们呼喊的那天，你们才可以呼喊。
Until the day I let you to shout, then shout.
你看，神吩咐他们绕城七日。
That God asked them to march around for 7 days.
前面的六天，每天绕一圈。
And the first 6 days is only one time.
第七天呢，就绕了七圈。
And on the seventh day, and seven times.
然后神对他们说：“你们绕城的时候，除了吹角声呢，你们不可呼喊。
And when you go round other than blowing the trumpets, do not give a war cry.
不可让人听见你们的声音。
Do not raise your voice.
连一句话也不可出口。
And do not even say a word.
就是要安静去等候，等到神吩咐你们呼喊的那天，你们才可以呼喊。
Be still and wait until the day the Lord said you can shout, then shout.
呼喊的时候，耶利哥城就会倒塌。
And the Jericho wall will come down when you shout.
你看这是多么不可思议的事情。
This is something that's unthinkable.
是完全不合乎逻辑的。
And it's beyond logic.
这个必须要极大的信心才能够去相信，才能够去信靠神的。
And you must have great faith to believe and trust God.
万一仇敌开门出来攻打他们，他们就要被杀害了。
What if the enemy opened the gate and killed them?
但是他们却要全心的相信去。等待神的时间。
And yet they have to trust God wholeheartedly for His timing.
今天在你的生命当中呢，也许也有很多好像耶利哥城一样的铜墙铁壁。
Today, maybe in your life, it's just like Jericho wall. You have couple and iron walls surrounding you.
那些看起来是不可能克服的问题。
It seems those problems that you cannot solve.
而你也在绕着这些的问题转了很多圈。
And you're circling around these problems again and again.
可能是你生命中的病痛。
It could be your illness.
可能是你的财务债台高筑。
And maybe your financial problems.
可能是你很多的不能够放下的事情。
And maybe a lot of matters that you cannot let go.
一些不能够饶恕的人。
And even some unforgiveness.
或者是坏习惯。
Or bad habits.
黑暗权势的捆绑。
And the power of the darkness.
又或者是人与人之间有很多的无形的高墙
，and even the invisible high wall between people，
夫妻之间、父母跟儿女之间
，between husband and wife and parents with children，
家人之间那高大又坚韧的高墙
，the high walls between members of the family。
但是只要我们继续的安静的依靠神、仰望神
，but we just have to be still and trust God。
我们就要期待看见耶利哥城。倒塌的那一刻
，Then we must expect to see the wall of Jericho coming down one day.
在哥林多后书第十章第三节第五节，保罗这里说，我们虽然在世上行事，却不是按照世俗的方式作战。
2 Corinthians says, For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does.
在和合本就说，虽然在血气中行事，却不凭着血气征战。
Another version that says the same.
因为我们所作战所用的兵器不是属于这世界的。
Because the weapons we fight are not the weapons of the world.
而是在神的面前有能力的可以攻坚坚固的堡垒。
But on the contrary, they have the divine power to demolish the arguments.
攻破诡辩，合作来阻挡人认识神的一切的高墙，并且把人一切的心意夺回来，顺服基督。
And every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God, and take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ.
有些圣经的学者就认为耶利哥城的意思就是月城。
That some scholars say Jericho is the moon city.
就是膜拜月亮的中心。
It's a center to worship the moon.
是一个偶像权势所捆绑的地方。
That is bound by idolatry.
今天也许你的家人，他们的心也如耶利哥城。
Maybe some of your family members are like this Jericho wall.
好像高大的这个铜墙铁壁。
It's like this copper and iron wall.
他们的心门紧紧的封闭。
That their hearts are closed tightly.
不向主耶稣敞开，不向福音来敞开。
Not opening to Jesus or even to the gospel.
然后你围着这个墙已经祷告了很久。
And you've been praying around this wall for a long time.
看起来是分文不动的。
As though it's not moving.
甚至你有些时候想到要放弃了。
Sometimes you feel like even giving up.
但是圣经告诉我们呢，今天我们不是用我们的血气来征战。
And yet today the Bible says the weapons we fight are not the weapons of the world.
只要今天你不放弃。
As long as you don't give up.
你可以在神的面前有能力的可以攻陷这些坚固的堡垒。
That you will have divine power to demolish strongholds.
去攻破这些的诡辩，和做来阻挡人认识神的一切的高墙。
And every arguments and pretension that set itself against the knowledge of God.
那些隔在神与人之间的不信的墙。
The wall that divide God and unbelief.
人与人之间不信任的墙。
And even the trust between people.
可以把它在神的面前拆毁。
And all this will come down before the Lord.
并且把一切的心意都夺回来。
And take captives of every thought.
使他们都顺服基督。
And to make it obedient to Christ.
弟兄姐妹们，只要我们不放弃。
Brothers and sisters, as long as we don't give up.
只要我们继续在神的面前用祷告去围绕他们。
As long as we use prayer to surround them.
我们将会看到最终的胜利。
That we will see the final victory.
我们将会看到我们的全家，我们的家人都归向主。
That we can see our whole family will return to the Lord. Amen.
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 所以你们要休息，要知道我是神。
Therefore, be still and know that I am God.
所以神说，你们要休息，要知道我是神。
Therefore, the Lord says, be still and know that I am God.
不要误会我的意思。
Please do not misunderstand me.
休息不是说我们不需要再祷告了。
Be still does not mean that we stop praying.
其实我们现在比过去任何的时候更需要祷告。
Actually, now we need to pray even more compared to before.
我们更需要更多的时间来求告神。
We need more time to cry out to the Lord.
但是我们要在安静中去仰望神。
But in stillness, look to God.
休息并不是一个的负面的、消极的、一个的被动的、无奈的意识形态。
Rest does not mean it's negative, pessimistic, and helplessness.
休息是在我们的内心里面以积极、正面、乐观、活泼的信心去等候神、去仰望神、去寻求神，把一切都交托给他。
Yes, rest means aggressively positive, optimistic, active faith, wait upon, look to, seek the Lord, and to entrust all things to Him.
Amen.
Amen.
所以今天我们看到安静是要我们仰望神、观看神的作为。
Therefore, today we look. Rest is for us to look to God and watch His deeds.
神通过摩西吩咐以色列的百姓：你们要安静。不要惧怕，要观看神为你们征战，观看神在你们当中的作为。
God told Moses to let the Israelites know to rest and look to God and watch the deeds of the Lord.
我们也看到，安静是要信靠神，等待神的时间。
Next, we see resting in God means trust in God and wait for His timing.
约书亚吩咐他们要安静。
Joshua asked them, "Be still."
等到神的时间到了。 就呼喊，城墙就倒塌。
Wait until the Lord's timing, shout, then the wall will come down.
你看神做事有他自己的时间。
God has his own timing in his work.
神创造天地万物的时候，到了第七天，当他达到目标的时候，他就安息了，他就卸下了手中的工作。
After creating for the first 6 days, God rested on the seventh day.
然后神带领以色列的百姓绕城七日之后，达到了目标了，耶利哥城就倒塌了。
And the Lord led the people to march around, and on the seventh day, when he reached the purpose, he rested.
所以让我们在安静中信靠神，等待神的时间到来。
Therefore, rest and trust in God and wait for his timing.
今天我就分享到这里。
Today I will stop here.
好，下一次我会跟大家分享呢，安静是要顺服神，遵守神的法则。
Next, I will share with you, rest is to submit to God and obey His words.
然后还有安静等候神，经历神的同在。
And wait upon God and experience His presence.
安静转向神，明白神的心意。
Rest is to turn to God and understand His purpose.
安静聆听神，知道神的计划。
Rest is to hear from God and know His plans.
这些是我在这过去的几天所领受的信息。
And these are the messages that I received myself the last few days.
但是今天只是跟大家先分享两点。
But I've just shared 2 points with you.
我们以后再继续的分享。
And I will continue to share this.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray.
天父，我们感谢你，你爱我们。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for loving us.
你看见我们在人生中的许多的劳苦愁烦。
That you have seen many troubles in our lives.
你听见我们内心中的呼喊。
And even you heard our cries.
听见我们向你的求告。
And you heard our prayers.
主啊，你知道我们的苦情。
That you know our troubles.
主啊，谢谢你来拯救我们。
Thank you for saving us.
主啊，叫我们懂得安静在你的面前。
That we know how to be still before you.
主，我们把我们的祷告交托之后。
That when we surrender our prayers.
我们就平静安稳的仰望你。
We can be still and look to you.
我们要观看你在我们生命中奇妙的作为。
We want to watch your deeds in our lives.
主啊，求你透过我们的生命彰显你的荣耀。
That you manifest your glory through our lives.
叫我们真知道你是神。
That to know that you are God.
也让我们周边的亲人朋友也看见你在我们生命里面彰显的大能和荣耀。
And even friends and relatives around us can see your manifested glory in our lives.
以致他们的心也能够转向你。
That our hearts can turn to you.
主啊，帮助我们坚定的信靠你。
Lord, help us to trust you wholeheartedly.
纵然遇见看起来不能够突破的困境。
Even though there are predicaments that cannot have breakthroughs.
但是我们相信你有你的时间。
And yet we believe you have your time.
主啊，当你的时机临到的时候，你就必做成你要做的事。
And when the moment comes, you will accomplish what you need to do.
我们感谢你如此的交托感恩。
We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. 感谢神。在这里，我也想为那些还不认识耶稣基督的朋友亲戚来祷告。
Here I want to pray for friends and relatives who do not know Jesus yet.
如果你要接受这一位全能的神作为你的天父。
If you want to accept this God as your heavenly Father,
把你生命中的一切的问题、苦难、一切的挣扎都交托给他。
So that you can surrender your struggles and your problems to Him.
你要邀请主耶稣基督成为你生命的主和救主。
You can invite Jesus to be your personal Savior.
好像你可以成为上帝的儿女。
So that you can be children of God.
你就可以跟着我一起来祷告。
You can pray together with me.
我说一句，你可以跟着我说一句。
You pray after me.
亲爱的天父上帝
，Heavenly Father，
谢谢你爱我。
Thank you for loving me。
你看见我人生的劳苦愁烦
，That you have seen my troubles，
内心的痛苦和挣扎
，And the pains within me，
所面对的许多挑战和难处
，And challenges and problems ahead of me。
谢谢你来救我
，Thank you for saving me，
帮助我
，Helping me。
我求主耶稣基督成为我生命的主
，I invite Jesus to be my personal Savior，
我生命的救主
，And the Lord of my life，
赦免我的罪
，And forgive my sin，
除去我与你之间的一切的。
And to remove all hindrances between you and me.
好叫我可以认识你。
So that I can know you.
亲近你。
To come close to you.
求告你。
To cry out to you.
在安静中仰望你。
And to be still and look to you.
在安静中信靠你。
And rest and trust you.
借着你的帮助，我可以成为一个得胜的人。
Then I will be an overcomer by your help.
我的生命彰显你的荣耀。
Let my life manifest your glory.
我如此感恩祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名。
I give thanks and pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
恭喜你接受了耶稣基督。
Congratulations, you have accepted Jesus.
那么你就是基督徒，就是上帝的儿女。
As a Christian, you are a child of God.
如果你想更多的认识关于神的事
If you want to know more about God
教会可以帮助你
The church can help you
你就可以联络那一位邀请你来观看这个视频的基督徒朋友
You can contact the person who have invited you to watch this online services
他会来帮助你
He will come and help you
谢谢
Thank you
所以主耶稣祝福你
May the Lord bless you
带领你走人生的道路
And guide you into the path of life
也奉主耶稣基督名祝福每一位弟兄姐妹
And bless every brother sister
祝福每个家庭
Every family
我们相信主与我们同在
That God is with us
不管环境如何
No matter how the situation is
不管我们面对任何的挑战
No matter how the challenges ahead
我们都不需要惧怕
We do not have to fear
因为神与我们同在
Because God is with us
他为我们征战
He will fight for us
他带领我们得胜
He will help us to win Amen
荣耀归给我们的主耶稣基督
Glory unto the Lord Amen
Amen
Oh, I want to share a testimony for this moment
我师母在这个时候有个感动要分享一个见证
This Bible verse is 2 Corinthians 10 that we just look at
刚才我们看到的一节节的经文哥林多后书的第十章
That the Holy Spirit has guided me to use this verse to pray for my father's salvation
就是当年呢圣灵就用这节的经文来帮助我为我的父亲的救恩来祷告
Because to me, for him to become a Christian It seems just like the Jericho wall is so impossible
因为当时看起来呢要他接受耶稣呢就好像耶利哥城那么的困难是不可能的事情
Yet I believe that time when Holy Spirit prompted these words in my mind I use these words to proclaim over his life
但是当圣灵感动我的时候我就引用这些的经文呢宣告进入他的生命
That God will demolish all arguments and all pretension that come against the knowledge of God
就是神会拆毁一些的人的诡辩一切的属灵的营垒
Because of his career he's surrounded by the things of the world I do not see the impossible things but I see my God who is the God of impossible
虽然当时候呢因着他的环境呢信主是不大可能的事情但是我看见的在神凡事都可能
And after praying for 33 years
结果就是祷告了33年之后呢
Claiming that words that say taking captives of all his thoughts and make it obedient to Christ
就是抓住那个应许神会叫把人的心意夺回叫他归顺基督
Every day whenever I pray I say Lord you take captives of my father's thought and make it obedient to Christ
所以每一天我就宣告主啊你把我的父亲的心意夺回叫他能够顺服基督
And on 2015 June 14
就在2015年的6月14号
Both my parents raised their hand to signify that they want to become Christian
我的父母亲呢同时之间呢他们就举起手来要接受耶稣基督成为生命的救主
It was the happiest day of my life
那是我生命中最开心的一天
Not only we rejoice when we see our parents coming to the Lord
不只是我们为了我们的父母的得救我们心里面充满喜乐
I'm even more joyful that the promises of God had been fulfilled
我更喜乐的是神的应许已经成就
So I encourage brother sister to use the word of God to pray for your problems and your difficulties
所以鼓励弟兄姐妹们你就抓住神的这个应许呢为你的问题为你的挑战来宣告祷告
Amen Glory to God
Amen 荣耀归给神
Amen
Amen 谢谢师母的分享再见
所以我要小心一遍一遍不停来宣告
每天
他的应许
都完全成就
所以我要一遍一遍不